Is it okay to drink a pint of Gerolsteiner mineral water every day? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Anonymous says, I love Gerolsteiner and drink about one pint per day. Yeah, I did before Amazon Fresh ran out of it. Should there be anything I should be concerned with about this? Is this too much for any reason? One pint strikes me as very little Gerolsteiner. So a bottle of Gerolsteiner... They come in... Is it 1 liter? Okay, so a bottle is one pint and 9.3 fluid ounces. So I guess it's a little bit over a pint and a half. Is that right? It's less than it's significantly less than a bottle. I don't think so, because I generally, if I have it available, often drink 1.5 to 2 bottles of Gerolsteiner in a day. I guess conceivably, if you're also drinking a lot of milk or eating a lot of cheese or supplementing with calcium or taking bone meal powder, I guess you could get too much calcium. I wouldn't really worry about it from one pint. I do think that the main concern with carbonated beverages of any type is that you have too much acid running over your teeth a lot. So I think it's wise to drink this in a way that tends to bypass your teeth. And I think you can kind of do that when you're drinking from the bottle. I mean, you can do it more effectively if you use a straw, but I think you can manipulate the bottle in your mouth to kind of pour it beyond your teeth, which I think is a good thing to do. I think the wider the mouth of the jar you're drinking it at, like if you pour it into a glass and you don't have a straw, you're probably a lot more likely to have more of it running over your teeth. And probably the best thing that you can do for that is before you brush your teeth, make sure that you swish with water. Or if you really wanted to be anal about it, baking soda. My understanding of the dentistry of it is that having acids pass by your teeth in and of itself is not the biggest concern. The main concern would be weakening the enamel and the mineral matrix with, bathing the teeth in something acidic for a long period of time, and then coming in with a toothbrush and scraping all of the weakened enamel off your teeth or all the weakened mineral out of it. Ever since I started drinking Gerolsteiner, I really crave it. And I think that's because my body has been wired to understand that it gets the minerals from it. And so I'm not really anal about this. Maybe I should be more anal than I am. But my approach is basically, drink it so that from the bottle, feeling like it's, not going in front of my teeth, it's going behind them in terms of the stream of water. And then don't drink a bottle of it and then go brush my teeth. I would instead, if I drank it recently, I would swish with water. If I drank it a long time ago, I wouldn't worry too much about it. But that's the way that I look at that. All right. Thank you, Anonymous, for your question. Hope that helped.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. For the remainder of 2020, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.